A day after the release of a Senate report detailing the widespread security failures in the January 6th Capitol riot, our Lisa Desjardins sat down for an exclusive interview with one of the police officers who was on the scene that day.
It was a chaotic scene marked by tragedy and heroism. Officer James Blassingame, 17-year veteran of the Capitol Police, thank you for joining us. You're here along with your lawyer, Patrick Malone, who's representing you, and a fellow officer in a civil lawsuit against former President Trump over harm done from the January 6th riot. He requested to be present for this interview. Tell me what happened that day.
That's something that I try to process and go through from time to time. What happened? How did it happen? It was an insurrection, you know. It was a significant amount of people that felt aggrieved and felt that invading the Capitol to impose their will was an appropriate action. It looked like a horde of zombies, you know, just people as far as you can see, just salivating and
faces and bodies and
yeah, and they're tugging on the officers, and you know, they're in danger. And there's nothing we can do. And then I hear somebody yell, they're coming in a window. So go towards the north side, the center side of the Capitol. And there was some door. Nobody can get inside the door. You know, that Capitol was kind of an old place and mm-hmm. some things antiquated. So we roll out towards the center of the rotunda looking north. And you just hear just noise and people running at me as far as I can see, from the crypt all the way to the north side, center side of the Capitol, just running at us. And I look to my left and to my right, and there's like maybe 8-9 of us, and I'm thinking, sorry. And they kind of leak out. And there's like we're holding a line, but there's no line we're holding because there's an insurmountable amount of people, and there's like 8-9 officers. And
it's a massive space.
I'm 39 years old. I've never been called a to my face in 39 years. Might have been called a but I've never been called one to my face. Mm. That streak ended on January 6th. Mm. I was called a I was called a traitor. I was called, you know, various epithets.
What are you thinking at this point? How are you making decisions?
I don't want to make it seem like braggadocious, like there was no fear. Like, absolutely, there had to have been some fear, but I don't think there was time for fear. It was, I have to make it home. Like, I have to survive this. I've been on a department 17 years. I've never been in a situation where I felt I had to use my weapon. That was a situation where I was pegging. I was like, okay, this is it. And the only reason why I didn't do it was because the mentality was this is a four-alarm blaze. And if I pull my gun out and start shooting, I'm throwing kerosene on it. Hmm. Maybe there's a chance I survive if I don't pull my weapon. But if I do, I'm probably not gonna make it out of here alive, you know? You don't have enough bullets.
I wanna help people understand that we've seen a lot of pictures from outside of the Capitol. The places you were some of the most dangerous and difficult confrontations in the Capitol, but you weren't unharmed.
I would say it's much more like emotional and mental than anything else, you know? Because we can't really move past it. You know, we're something as simple as a commission, you know, being passed or, you know, trying to take that on, you know, at the end of the day, as bad as it was, like, we did our job. Like, no member of Congress was harmed, you know? And to have to see these people every day and they don't have our back, something as simple as just trying to find out what happened so that it doesn't happen again, because my fear is this was the tip of the iceberg. You know, you have a lot of people that are radicalized, that this is exactly what they wanted to do, you know? And by there being no accountability, it's emboldening them.
I want to play some sound of what some lawmakers have said in recent months, a different narrative from Republican lawmakers who question whether how serious January 6th was. I want to play that and get your thoughts on it, if you can listen.
Okay.
You know, if you didn't know the TV footage was a video from January the 6th, you would actually think it was a normal tourist visit.
Was January 6th an insurrection, or could it be more accurately described as a mob of misfits?
I condemn the violence, but to say there were thousands of armed insurrectionists breaching the Capitol, intent on overthrowing the government, is just simply false narrative.
What do you say?
I would think that certain things are above politics. It's deplorable to say, as bad as it looks on film, believe me, it was much worse. You know, they can stitch together as much footage as they want to, but I'm telling you, and anybody that was in that scrum will tell you, it was much worse in person than anything you're ever gonna see on film. And for the narrative to be modified or changed so that it's trying to make it seem something other than what it was, it's disheartening, you know? Especially, you know, we go to work every day and we have to protect, you know, members of Congress, and for them to come and say, you know, thank you for your service and appreciate what you do, but you don't, because this is very simple. Just having a commission to find out what happened so this doesn't happen again, you know? Because I personally feel that, again, this is something that is a very real threat moving forward.
Your lawsuit charges President Trump himself with directing and enabling this attack. Why focus on him? Why do you believe he's responsible?
Well, there's no shortage of people that are responsible, but I think that just being a pragmatic person and seeing the timing of events and how things unfolded, and to feed people incorrect narrative for months, and then to have them come to the city at the time that they're gonna certify the votes, then to whip people up and say, we're gonna go down Pennsylvania Avenue, and to as a president, to use the bully pulpit. I mean, that, how does that not mean something? You know, the president of the United States, this is the most powerful human being on the planet. If the most powerful human being on the planet is not held accountable, can do whatever they want to do, what does that say about our democracy as a whole?
And we've reached out to the former president for comment on your lawsuit. We have not heard back from them at this point. Do you think the U.S. Capitol is secure right now?
I don't think I'm qualified to answer that question.
Respect. James Blassingame, Patrick Malone, thank you very much for talking with us and sharing your story.
Thank you.
Good to be with you.